1 John 1:9 says, if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from unrighteousness. James 5:16 says that we should confess our sins one to another. So we're supposed to confess our sins to God, and we're supposed to confess our sins to one another. And I think very few of us practice confessing our sins to one another. I know I've been guilty of this many times. What are the benefits of obeying God in this? He says confess your sins, and we know that there's always blessing when we obey God. So what are the known benefits of confessing our sins? Number one, I think it helps us with our pride. And I think all of us could use some more humility in our lives. How much less prideful would you be on Sunday morning if you had to walk into church with all of your sins that you committed that week written on a shirt, and you weren't allowed to cover it up with a jacket? Pride issues probably wouldn't be there in the church anymore if each one of us knew what each other was doing or had committed that week, what sins had been committed that week. So it helps us with our pride. It helps you feel loved, and it gives you a chance to show love. When you confess your sins to somebody and they forgive you and show you love, you feel loved. When you are the person that's being confessed to, you have an opportunity to love somebody. So it gives us multiple opportunities to love. It also gives us accountability. The reason we confess our sins to God is for forgiveness. We confess our sins to one another for accountability, because this life is difficult and we need accountability. As long as we're fighting the flesh, the devil, all the different temptations of this world, we need accountability. So we need one another, iron sharpening iron. I don't know why it is that we've stopped confessing. Maybe it's the Catholic Church having their confessionals that makes us think, hey, we're Protestant, we don't do the confessional thing. Yes, we don't do the confessional thing, but we definitely follow what the Bible says, which James 5:16 says, confess our sins to one another. When I confess my sins to people, it definitely causes me to be more humble. When I realize my spiritual bankruptcy, I get to experience the kingdom of heaven. That's what James 5:3 says. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. So when we're lower in spirit or humble in spirit, when we drop our knee like we did the day we got saved, drop to our knees like the day we got saved, and we say, I'm a sinner, I need your help, God. When we do that to each other, and we don't say, hey, I've got it figured out, I've been a Christian for a long time, but I still need God every single day. That's what the poor in spirit looks like. It's those that realize their need for a Savior every single day. And they realize it so much that they're willing to be accountable to people and willing to ask for forgiveness of their sins. I hope this encourages you this week. See you guys at church.